following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do a great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Release the need to be right. When you believe something, you assume you're right. It may even destroy relationships in order to defend your position. Let go of the need to defend your position. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 129, NASDAQ off 61, S&P's off 18.5, gold contract up $1.90, trading 12.86 an ounce. You get silver flat, $15.09 an ounce. Light sweet crude, had some action out here today in the crude market. Went down yesterday, had a little pop when the numbers came out. Guess what? Gave it up. Light sweet crude down 42 cents, trading 56.13. Notes and bonds still want higher price. You had the 10-year note up 9 ticks, trading 122.05. 30 years up a half a point or 16 ticks, trading 144.29. And King Dollar. King Dollar's up 10 ticks, 96.805. King Dollar, it's going to be a subtle deal, but it looks like King Dollar's going to fail on price out here today. Volume has been contracting since last Friday. The euro's trading at 113.07. The yen is at 111.80. And the pound is at 131.70 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in y'all world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We go over and take a look at the SPY. What you're going to be looking for out here today, folks, is this. You have done 48 million shares thus far. The low out here that was established on Monday that it basically rejected had volume down there. That was 276.84. We hit 277.06. Bottom line, I expect as we're coming into, let's see, we've got to do more than 60 million. You're at 48 million right now. I suspect that that's what we're going to get, but we'll see. What I expect we're also going to be doing as we're coming into this close out here, this market is going to try to get to the lows of Monday. And we're fairly close to them right now. The SPY is, let's say, the SPY, the low out there, 276.84. Yeah, so the SPY is laying out there about 60 cents above them right now. You know, we'll see where this shakes out in the next 50 minutes. We take a look at the NDX 100. What do you have with the NDX? 19 million shares. Now, the NDX is going to also come in with more volume than yesterday. We'll see just how much. NDX also looks like it's going to try to get into the lows. Now, the difference with the NDX, I don't think it's going to actually get down to the 172.47. That would be quite a move from where we are right now. You know, we'll see whether I expect we'll attack the highs of that, which is like 172.94, which is only another 70 cents from where we are. Small caps. We take a look at the IWM inside the Russell 2000. Russell 2000, bottom line, it's leading the pack down. Now, this is really important to wrap your head around, folks, because what had happened in October, is that it was the small caps that led the market lower. Now, these small caps, they are selling this off in an extraordinary way. You get volume that is blown out. We have 21 million shares traded. Yesterday, trying to get the highs at 16 million, okay? Big number. There's nothing holding this back. I mean, you know, what we just did in basically 5.5 hours, we just came back to February 14th. And it's always dangerous when you're trading sideways for a long period of time. And then traders, investors, well, traders more so, investors don't look at the market as much as traders. Bottom line, this is a break. This is a break, and the break is downtown. Now, the S&P hasn't broke yet. The NASDAQ hasn't broke yet. I expect you're going to see the S&P break next. This is a decisive break. And when you do a decisive break like this, let me put this on a weekly for a second. Okay, so on a weekly, you just broke down. So now you get your 153. 149 is game real easy. And you got 140. So bottom line is that it looks to me like you got this break that's happening right here, right now. And we'll see how we come into the close, because they can unload into the close pretty easily out here today. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract traded to a high today of 1291, low of 1284. Gold's going to need a lot more juice than this. We did 181,000 contracts. That's light contract volume. You're really going sideways. Bottom line, need higher price with volume. The GDX, which is inside the market, meaning the gold market, the equities, bottom line, that's testing the lows that were established out here on Monday. Now, you are doing that test with light volume, but it's not holding up. We're at 2152. 2140 is the number. You're going into it with 22 million shares versus 55. So the volume characteristic is good. The pricing is not good. And you're going to have Newmont. This is what's driving the GDX. And you're going to really wrap your head around this now. Newmont is down $1.16. We go to Barrick, ABX. Suspect that's going to ABX. Oh, no, it's not ABX anymore. That's right. It's GOLD. So Barrick, that's only down 29 cents. Interesting. So that means that it's Newmont that is the culprit here. Oh, excuse me, folks. And Goldcorp is down. Okay, so let's go look at the news on Newmont, because when I do this, the number here, what is going to happen, folks, is that there's no news. Newmont says Barrick meeting productive and good start. Newmont spokesman comments in an email that the outcome of Tuesday meetings between the leaders of the two largest gold companies they had a meeting. It was a good start. Now, that being said, what you have happening here, and I'll do these numbers at the break, what has happened is that the number is getting much closer to, with Newmont being down $1.14 and Barrick only being down 40 cents, the number is getting much closer to the number that Barrick is saying they want to take Newmont over for. That's what you have happening out here, which is pretty wild. And that's my take is that that's where this thing's going to go also. Let's go over to the E-minis again. They're going to sell this thing off. They could just, once I looked at that small caps, folks, this thing's going to get sold down. We take this. Yeah, so you're at 2771 right now. You got plenty of time to sell into that close. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere, hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live, and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow Industrials down 148, NASDAQ down 72, S&P's off 20. Over to our man, Mr. Steve Dahl, as we do each and every Wednesday. And folks, you know, we got a nice little market here that's consolidating, going back and forth. And if you want a tool to wrap your head around as to understanding, number one, where this market's going and where the support is, where the resistance is, come over to our website. You're going to see it right under featured content. TAS Profile Scanner. Steve's the president of TAS Market Profile, and these profiles, folks, they can pick it up, and they pick it up in a split second as to, let's just talk the S&P 500, where the equities are going inside the S&P 500, and we're going to let Steve explain exactly how this works, but it is really cool as the aspect in real time, folks, where those 500 stocks are going in relationship to where these profiles are. Steve Dahl, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom, how are you? How are you? Can't help but on a day like today, the season for sacrifice and giving something up, I can assure you I'm not giving up my Wednesdays with you, so don't worry.
I like it. So what are you going to give up? Yeah, it's first
your
day of
boy.
Lunch.
You know, most of the time on the show here, those that are in the Tiger Den watching, you only get to see the top half of me. I probably could give up the way I like to eat. Maybe some of these Chicago steakhouses need to be a little arm's distance away from me because I could lighten up a little bit in the midsection.
Steaks are great for you. It's the pizza. I love both
true.
Steaks and pizza. And what happens, folks, is I try to stop eating pizza. I can eat steak all day long. Pizza, man, oh, my God, it's so good.
I don't know if I could survive that, giving up Chicago steak and Chicago pizza.
No,
come on.
No, you wouldn't. No, just the pizza. The steak's great for you, man.
Oh, man.
So,
yeah,
listen,
wild markets.
You know, you heard, and folks, yeah, first off, folks, when you, the way you get the TAS profile, let's go through this. The way you get the TAS profile, number one, is that when you're on the front page of TFNN, bottom line, you see in the featured content, you see our man Steve Dahl, all his videos are there, okay? They're great videos, folks, to understand exactly how this works, okay? And it's a very simple, clean system. And you hit subscribe down the very bottom. You can listen to the videos first. It's only $97 a month. First month, 30-day money-back guarantee, folks. Nothing to lose, everything to gain. So, Steve, I have your screen up here, right? And, you know, on a day like today, which is pretty cool, is that, you know, we've had these S&Ps move around a bit. And if you could just explain to them, like, when we look at, yeah, perfect, if you get the breath market up right now, if you can just take it over from here.
Absolutely. So one of my favorite features when I'm trying to make sense of a volatile S&P market in this case is we don't just want to be chasing price or where the index is trading. That's, you know, that's just the receipt of what's happening. Everybody sees it. And so many traders are chasing price action, what has already happened, that Kodak moment of the market.
Yes.
What we do with market breadth, or what we also call market internals, is we break down and we start kind of taking a chip count. I like to say it's like a poker game between the bulls and the bears. And if you draw your attention over to the left of my screen here in the
yes.
market breadth screen, this is a 60-minute time horizon and a simple line chart down at the bottom. So what you see over here, you see in the red text, it says below, and it says 346. That means 346 of the S&P 500 stocks are bearish on a one-hour time frame. I mean, that's two-thirds of the marketplace.
How cool is that? Yeah, I know.
And you could see, if you bring, you know, look over to the hard right edge over here, you could see that it's way up here. The red line is very clear visually up there. The bears are in control. And look what the market's done. We're down 20-some points here, and it'd be just a, you know, a great bias to have. So you can put on the bear put spreads if you're doing options. You can look at SPY and SPX and take bearish positions on a day like today, and you already will be better off than, you know, most other market participants that are still trying to figure out which way to trade this market.
Yes. Now, what's really cool, folks, so Steve has this up in a 60-minute chart, right? You can bring this down to any type of time frame you want. And what is really cool, whether it's the 30, and what you're going to see, now this is how real time this is. I think this is the one of the most powerful things inside your little piece of software here. And what it is, as you know, these equities, they're not all going to stay above the profile or below the profile. But as that is happening, folks, you can actually see it happen, which is just amazing, okay? So we know that markets love going up and down. And these markets in particular, because we've been at the same, really, 25 S&P points, 30 S&P points for, you know, almost 2.5 weeks now. And that is powerful in the aspect of it's a real-time change. So when they change, guess what? You're going to see either the bullish ones go higher, the bearish ones go lower, or vice versa. It's so cool, man, how this thing shakes out. And then, of course, what you do have, you know, and this is why I want you to listen to these videos, folks, because what happens is that the more that you watch this, the more that you can really wrap your head around it. If you have spikes that are too bearish or too bullish, well, guess what? Any second that thing's going to turn around. Those spikes are really
exactly.
true. Yeah.
They really are. I think it sounds like you use it in the same way that I do, where it's like, you know, when the market gets into these circumstances, like look back here in time. I happen to actually have a four-hour time frame up here. So this is going back to – this is actually Christmas Eve where I have my cursor for those of you watching in the den.
Yes.
And notice how the bears at this point, 96%
right.
were bearish at that time. This is Christmas Eve, folks. Do you remember?
I mean, that was a low.
Yep. It was ugly. You guys remember that? I was thinking about returning Christmas presents at that time. And what we ended up seeing was this. Look at how easily you started to see the bulls mount a comeback. That green line starts kind of coming up here. You get the crossover. And this is the bulls saying, see you later. Don't count us out before we you know, get ready to take a head of steam into the new year. And you see this in the market reaction down below. So it's simple. Look, the S&P is a complex instrument. It really is. You know, with the millions of contracts traded every day, bulls and bears and everywhere in between.
Sure.
It's a very complicated instrument to trade if you don't have some insight that looks deeper inside the price than just the price alone.
No, there's no doubt. And, you know, what has happened, folks, is that Steve's made it easy because you want to go over these videos. You know, you can take a look at a piece of software and say, okay, what does this mean? What does that mean? Bottom line, if you go over the videos, you're going to see you're going to see how complex it is. Because once you really start understanding it, the complexity is not you hitting a button. The complexity is that it's hard to comprehend that it's actually doing that much work when you're right in front of it. You know,
exactly.
Yeah.
It is. It's one of those things, you know, for many, you know, we rolled this thing out several years ago. And we actually originally created this for one of our institutional bank trading customers. These are professional commercial level traders that loved our analytics and algorithms, but they said, hey, can you create a tool that helps our traders at our prop desk find opportunities more efficiently? And so we created what was the early versions of what is now known as the TAS profile scanner, and they still use it to this day. So it's kind of like you get this same type of tool, time-saving tool, as even a professional caliber bank trading customer of ours utilizes. So that's pretty cool.
It's huge. And what happens, folks, if you happen to be watching Tiger TV right now, you're going to see on the right-hand side, you're going to see Apple, then you're going to see underneath it, they give you the time frames, meaning that how is it set up in the long term? How is it set up in the short term? How is it set up in the daily? How is it set up in the weekly? In verbiage, that's, you know, there's one thing, if you haven't even looked at a chart, you don't even have to look at it. The bottom line is that they're spelling it out. And, you know, Steve, you know what's so amazing, man? It blows my mind that technology in general can not only do this, but that it can spit out the long term, intermediate term, short term, like on a continual basis, over and over and over again. Pretty amazing.
Embrace the technology, I'm telling you. Don't take the human out of the trade. Just add the efficiencies of technology and keep yourself in the pilot seat.
You gotta love it. Listen, man, you have a great week, safe week. Stay warm. Don't cut out too much. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at Amazon. So they're doing a lot of different things fast. There's no two ways about that, folks. So Amazon right now is down $22. They just this came across at, 20 minutes ago. Amazon shutting all its 87 U.S. pop-up stores, the Journal just reported. They were speculating this a couple of days ago, but bottom line, they're shutting them down. It's not immediately clear if any Amazon pop-up stores outside the U.S. Is going to be affected. The closings are expected by the end of April. the company is expanding bookstores in its so-called four-star stores that sell products rated 4 stars or higher by Amazon customers. Amazon told workers that they will receive a severance pay if they stayed until the end of April. And I'm not quite sure what the where they have these pop-up stores, but bottom line is that they are moving. The thing that's amazing, it really looks like Amazon is moving into retail, folks. I mean, that's, you know, they have it all, but it looks to me like, man, these guys are moving into retail in a big way. GE, bottom line, you know, this is a classic on GE, folks. This is what you have on GE. So GE's down 75 cents today. So picture this. GE last week was trading $11.29. You're at 9.14. And if you take a look at this, you're going to see, if you want to see a test that failed, this is a classic. And here you go. So we popped up to, what's that, 11.27. Yeah, 11.29 here. So watch this. This is just amazing. So your ICE, you know, I talk about ICE a lot. Now, ICE is a term Richard Wyckoff basically invented. I think he invented it anyway. That what it is, what ICE specifically is this. They're large bars that you're either jumping higher after consolidation or getting trashed after consolidation. And in this particular case, ICE is set up at $11.27. Now, this is after been a long downtrend for GE. So the volume at ICE is 1.17 billion, okay, on a weekly basis. Now, watch this. This is so cool. What do? You come off the lows of $6.40. You get up to 2 pennies above it. You went to 11.29. You closed under it. You closed at 10.27. This is on a weekly. Bottom line, gives it up. Now we'll watch how this thing shakes out, because what you do have, of course, inside GE is the huge problem for GE is that this wasn't even a bounce. You know, it seems that, you know, what you're going to be facing with GE on a continual basis is that because GE is GE, General Electric, always had a great name, it's going to be hard for the press in general to say that, okay, maybe this is it. Maybe this is it. Maybe this is it. You know, because unless you have dug into those numbers, and anyone in Wall Street that has dug into those numbers knows that you still have no transparency. That's GE's problem. Zero transparency. Any type of transparency that we've actually had always turns into monster losses. And in this particular case where this came out right from the CEO that they're going to go into a cash burn. Okay. So GE is not only in trouble, I think it's in monster trouble, because it couldn't even do a 0.23 retracement from its moved from $31. Let's see, we're at $31 in December of 2016. You are down into $6.40 in December. Now, you're going right after it again, man. That's the bottom line. What has happened here is this. Once we broke $10.35, you have game on now to the low, which is $6.40. And if you bring this back, I believe when we did this, I don't think it hit this yet. $5.50. No, it still hasn't hit it. So what GE wants to hit, folks, is that $5.50 is the high volume low from the 9th, from 2009. Hasn't been hit yet. It's going after that, baby. And we'll find out what are the skeletons that GE has in its closet. And I suspect, guess what? We're going to be all surprised how many are actually out there. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today, and we'll see whether we do get an expansion of volume. GE is the biggest. They've done $170 million. Abercrombie and Finch, bottom line, they get some juice. That's up 15%, up $4.33, trading $25.68. Advanced Micro's down $1. You got Micron Technology down $2. Ford's off $0.17. You get Sprint down 23. Roco is up $3. Let's go take a look at Roco. This thing has been on fire, man. So they must have, they have this thing together. The low is 26, the high 77. Let's see what they had to say. People just buying it. Well, so that this just got raised at a broker dealer, Guggenheim, to $77. Bottom line, they're just buying it. That's how that seems to be. We take this, bring this back, see what kind of money that they're pulling in. Yeah, that's, they're growing all right. They're growing by, their platform, folks, is growing by 102% over a three-year period. 102%. That's a monster. 2015, they took in $319 million. They're going for $1 billion this year. They took in $742 million last year. They're growing by leaps and bounds. Now, they're still losing money. This always, like, blows my mind. So picture that you're taking $1 billion and you lose 62 cents a share. That's how they're set up right now. And they're set up, they're going to take in 1.3 in 2020 and still lose 33 cents a share. But then if they're going by that same scale, that would mean that the next year they'd make money. And they have 78 million shares outstanding. Well, that's not that bad, actually. When you take a look at it, you know, those, you're growing like that and you can come into a profit. It doesn't take too long to flip that right around. Yeah, you get two more years, because realistically, the way that is set up, you go from a loss of 62 cents to a loss of 33 to flat to a gain of 33. And then, just as Amazon did, once they start gaining, it was pretty amazing. As if they, when you hit your expenses, then you bottom line start basically printing out money, deciding how much more do you want to put in expenses versus the bottom line. And you can see this. I just brought this up for Amazon. Look at this number. This is pretty amazing. 2015, they made $1.25. 2016, $4.90. 2017, $4.55. This year, they went from $4.55, folks, to $20, bottom line. Yeah, that's an expansion. Next year, they plan on going up an additional $6, $26. And then in 2020, you get another huge pop. They plan from going from $26 to $38 a share. That is a monster number. And particularly, you know, when you take a look at this, what they haven't even broken out yet, which they'll start breaking out, is their advertising deal. The advertising deal on Amazon is going to be a monster, man. We'll be talking about this 3 or 4 years from now, that that Google's going to have a slight problem as share gets distributed. Dow Industrials up one set, down 117. NASDAQ off 64. S&P's down 18. Come right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow down 110. NASDAQ is off 63. S&P's down 17 and a half. Let's go to those S&P's. We got right next to this number. We'll see whether we get down there. Pretty cool how this is shaking out. I forget what the number was. So we just got the 68 at 67.50. I love it. Okay. So we just came in coming into the close. Well, not coming into the close. We just spiked down to 68.50. And the number that we were looking at for Monday's close is a point above it. Battle's going to stay on here. Let's go to Robert in Kansas City. Hey, Robert, what's going on?
Hello. I was just calling today to see if you could talk to me about XOP, oil and gas industry.
Sure. Let's take a look at it. So the XOP, folks, is the S&P oil and gas exploration production ETF. Low for the year is 23, the high is 45. You're trading 29.54. Now, do you own this? You're looking to buy it? What are we doing, Robert?
Well, good question. I'm looking for an entry, and so my question to you is, do you think it'll go back to the February 8th value of 28.29, or do you think it'll go all the way back to the December 24 low of $24 and something?
Yeah, December 26. Yes. At 26. So the high in this.
That's where you think it's going to head in?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, what you have here, now this is really cool, folks, okay? So you can see what we've done out here today. It's subtle, but you have a big expansion of volume. You know, yesterday you're trying to get to a high out here with 12 million. You get 15 million down today. Now, what's so wild about this is this, folks, okay? If you go over to ExxonMobil, ExxonMobil's getting smoked out here today. Well, it's only down $1.20 now. It was down to $2.20 earlier. It has volume, and what that's all about is that ExxonMobil's gonna spend a fortune on basically exploration. So it's like, ooh, this is really interesting, you know, because guess what? When you spend a fortune on exploration, folks, it's not, Exxon doesn't do all its own exploration, but you know what I mean? So they can parcel that out. And the way this is just set up, Robert, I would, you know, I mean, the first step is going to be February 8th, no doubt, 27.95. You know, if it holds there, then it's going to be like, okay, that's not bad. But the buy would be a rejection of $26.68, which is the high of that low. Let me just put that on a weekly for a second. Yeah, and even on a weekly, you know, we've been at the same place. Yeah, on the weekly would be the same deal.
And can you talk to me a little bit about that? Because I just looked at the volume on XOP, and it didn't look like that high compared to the average. By the way, I'm a subscriber, and I've been reading the book that you wrote, and I really enjoy it. I think you're quite helpful.
Well, thank you so much. So this what ends up happening. If you're looking at average volume, what happens, folks, is that you can use whatever you want. I wouldn't use average volume. And the reason being is that what happens is this. What you want to know, what the theory is that where is the supply and demand curve, meaning that where are the buyers and where are the sellers laying out. So what tends to happen is this. As you're going higher, you want to gauge the volume into the highs. You know, and in this particular case, you know, yesterday you're going higher with 12.3 million. And, you know, bottom line is that, you know, you're coming into 29 million, you're coming into 23 million. You just put the crosshairs right across. That's the way I do that. And you just look for those high volume bars. You know, you're not looking for a high volume bar. It just happens that that's where the highs are. Okay. So that's saying you don't have enough buyers to go break topside. And then just the opposite, as it's coming down today, then you stay as close as you can, because the closer that you stay, the more probability that you're going to be accurate in your analysis. You know, like if you do when I do a 10-minute, I'm going to be a lot more accurate than a daily, than a weekly, than a monthly. That's just kind of how it works on that basis. Now, what happens, you can see the volume expand here, though, because yesterday we did 12.8. We're at 15.5 right now. And then if we look at this intraday, you're going to see some good spikes here somewhere. So, yeah, there's the spike at 13.10. Someone moved it out of 13.10. Someone tried to get it higher at 3.30, you know. So when you take...
That was my mistake. Don't use the average volume when you're trying to look at volume and look at the term price.
Yeah, so what you do is, what is it going against? That's every time is, what's it going against? You're going downtown, and this is what does happen. When you get high volume days, like we did at the lows, right? That actually, what happens there, folks, is this, is that the top of that is going to be good support, because whoever bought down there, you know, I'm talking about funds, right? What ends up happening is that at the high of that level, if you break into that level, it's a problem. If it rejects it, it's like, okay, now that's would be a large institution that's buying at that level and that supports the stock at that level. That's kind of how the theory goes.
All right, well, perfect. Thank you so much, man, for your help. I appreciate it.
You have a safe one. Have a great one, man. Appreciate it. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the XAU, the HUI bottom line. XAU out here, that's down $1.66. You're trading at 73.25. This is going after the lows of Wednesday, which is 72.95. We hit 73.07. Gold Bugs Index going to be the same thing. And the culprit out here is Newmont. There's no doubt. Newmont's got some good pullback going on. Oh, I like how this is set up, though. Still down 4.35. The differential is that you can just see that it never made it to that 161.98. We weighed 162.49. And what does happen is that you don't get the volumes inside the XAU HUI until 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, just kind of the way that ETF structure is set up. Let's go take a look at Franco Nevada, FNV. This is a quality royalty stock. Yeah, it's holding highs up there. So Royal Gold, take a look at Royal, down 77 cents. Now, this is going to be a good gauge of whether we're going to have volume or not. And this would be saying that, well, yeah, I better look at Newmont first. The Royal Gold would be saying that, no, we're not going to have volume on the way down. But let me just see Newmont. Newmont, 11.6. Yeah, same deal. You know, you're breaking into lows, but you're 11.6, and it's only done 9.48, and it's going against 10.12. You know, so that setup there is also saying that. Let's go look at a few more. Let's go look at Barrick. What I'm trying to assess here, folks, is that will there be volume or not inside of the XAU and the HUI tonight? And 14 million versus 12. Yeah, so that basically is saying that the XAU, HUI, you get a pullback to be on light volume. Price, though, price is right close to those lows of Monday. So That would be challenging coming into work tomorrow. There's no doubt about that. Dollar index, it's going to be subtle, but it looks like the dollar index is going to fail on price as well as volume. Dow Industrial's down 100, NASDAQ off 62, S&P's up 17.5. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark have launched a special for a limited time only. Save 25% off Primal Edge and Health Signals. Just use promo code HEALTH for Health Signals or use promo code PRIMAL for Primal Edge and save 25% off instantly when you sign up. All the details are available on each order page at TFNN. Certified personal trainer Nico DeHaan's newsletter Health Signals comes out twice a month and is packed with great information on health, fitness, and diet. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox, and contains a special blend of ionic soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form. This sale won't last long. Sign up now using promo code HEALTH for Health Signals or PRIMAL for Primal Edge and save 25%. For all the details, visit the front page of TFNN.com right now.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial's down 100, NASDAQ off 62, S&P's down 18. Percentage-wise out here, what you have the Dow Industrial's down 0.4, S&P 5, NASDAQ 0.8. The culprit out here today, and this one you better watch out for, folks, is that small cap. Small cap, bottom line, taking a hit. And as I said at the beginning of the show, when we started down in October, it was the small caps that started us. So what you have out here is that the small caps in 6.5 hours just took you back to Valentine's Day. That's how elevators go down in the marketplace. Pretty amazing, actually. You know, and if we take a look at the IWM, you're going to see the same type of setup. You got volume blasting out of this baby. We get volume out here of 26 million. You are going into 20 million, so it blew that away. And in the case of the IWM, you're back at the trading level of the 12th of February. Now, what you also have is this, is that the bottom line is that once you got under 154.48, bottom line, lows are wide open again. You know, what the small caps are doing, as is the S&P, is that they were going into the highs that were generated out here October, November, as well as December. And what you had out here with the small caps is that it gave it all up in spades, and very fast move, subtle move, and the subtleness of the move really has to do with, you know, it's a lot of folks don't look at the small caps on a continual basis. You better keep your eye on them, folks, because when they went south in October, it was fast and furious, and these turns take a bit, but I expect that what we can see right now, we're in the turn. If we go take a look at that bond market, you're going to see the same thing. It's like bonds just continue to claw their way higher. And, you know, bottom line is that we'll see whether that can continue. But guess what? It has continued on a pace. That is saying we're going to the top of the range again. The top of the range in the 10 right now is 122.28. Stay right there, folks. Going to be coming back with some numbers after the close. Recap out here. Dow Industrials down 118. NASDAQ off 65. S&P's off 18.5. We'll come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We have the Dow Industrials finished down 131, NASDAQ down 76, Down 70, rather. S&P's down 18. Percentage-wise out here, it was the NASDAQ that took the hit, down 0.9%. Well, actually, the Russell was down a lot more than that. Russell came down with volume as well as price. If you take a look at the IWM, you're going to see this is down $3, trading 153, 28 million shares traded. You bring this back, the IWM in 6 hours just got you back to the 12th of February. What it also did, folks, is that it got you back in the lower range, okay? It gave it up all three highs, the high of October 16th, the high of November 8th, as well as the high of December 3rd. Now, bottom line, what's game here is going to be December 26th. That's the number, and that is a very large number down there, by the way. And most times, you don't see just the small cap or just one indice turn. I expect what you're going to see is that you'll S&P's, the NASDAQ Composite, NDX 100, you'll see those babies also gather some steam. We did take a look at the S&P, the SPY, you're going to see you did expand on volume. Yesterday, trying to get, sideways at 59 million. Today, 68. You're going into the low of Monday, which had 106. So the way this is set up is that it stopped before it. The low is 276.84. We hit 276.97. Now, this is really dangerous for the bulls. You know, depending on how long you've been listening, you heard it many times. When you stop right before either a high or a low, and the market gets a chance to rest, big problem. And this particular case gets more energy up. The market's going to watch Asia trade all night. Market's going to watch Europe in the morning. And guess what? It's going to wake up with a little pep. And I expect you're going to go right after that low. And if you take that low out, which is the 276.84, you're going to be down to 273 in about a heartbeat because there's not much in between that. Because what that also is saying is that, bottom line, then the S&P is also going to be in the lower range. Notes and bonds, they're still saying market wants out. Yeah, the 10-year note up 11 ticks. 30-year up 19 ticks. We did have King Dollar fail. It's the first time we get a failure in King Dollar in quite some time. Got over the highs of yesterday, closed underneath it. King Dollar now going to go downtown. We'll see if we get any sellers on the way down. Dow Industrials closed down 133. NASDAQ off 70. S&P's off 18. Coming back with some numbers, folks. Stay right there.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show. It takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have. It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take him by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Always do your best. Express your own divinity. You don't need the acceptance of others. You don't need knowledge or great philosophical concepts. You have the right to be you and express yourself by being alive and loving yourself and loving others. Marketwise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 133, NASDAQ off 70, S&P's down 19.5, gold contract up $3.30, trading at $12.88 an ounce. We had silver flat, $15.10 an ounce, light sweet crude down 32 cents, $56.23 a barrel. Notes and bonds, higher price, lower yield. Gotta love it, man. Pretty amazing. You know, when you think about it, folks, you know, you go back like just 3 months, and like we figured that, hey, it's gonna be 3% all day long. Well, guess what? We're closer to the lows for the last year and the 10-year than we are to the highs, and in a dramatic way, too. Bottom line is that we are at 2.690. The low for the last full 12 months, this is 2.553, and the high is 3.237. So you can see we're a full 0.5% away from the high. Pretty amazing. King Dollar. King Dollar finally gave it up. Now, King Dollar, this is, you're talking about a subtle move and giving it up. It's pretty amazing, actually. And good old King Dollar, this is bulls and bears have been battling out here since October 23rd. And we'll see whether we're going to get any volume on the way down. You know, what has happened with King Dollar, pretty amazing. It's a tight range that we're in. You know, each time that it gets up to this top of this range, top of the range, approximately 96,900, gives it up on volume. Each time it gets down to the bottom of the range, which is 94,875, there's no more sellers. And so we had out here, you know, last Friday, you had King Dollar had a big day. It had 31,000 contracts traded, 30,000 contracts traded, came off the low. Guess what, though? Monday, what we did 16,000, but it stayed at higher price. Tuesday, went to higher price with 14,500. Now look at this. This is like so cool when this happens. Today, we got above it. We got the 96,940. Oh, look at that. No, the high yesterday is 96,950. We didn't spike it. Interesting. Okay. No, we didn't. We missed it by 10 one-hundredths. Bottom line, contraction of volume once again. And, you know, the I would have rather. Now, this is what ends up happening here. This actually wouldn't be a failure. You know, it didn't go higher because we didn't get over the high. That's what it had to do. Unreal. So, bottom line is that this thing can still go after this high. That's how this thing is set up. And, you know, we'll see where this shakes out. You know, it's been a tight range in a huge way. What has to happen for the dollar to basically get going is the euro. The euro, if we go over to the euro for a second, and I say get going the way down. What you have with the euro has been also trading in the exact same space since October 24th also. We're at 113.10. It's been bouncing along this bottom. And, you know, the range in the euro, the deep range is like 112 and the lows and 114 in the highs. So we're at 113.10 right now. You know, the pound has already come off the lows. The pound looks to me like it's going to go tremendously higher. You know, the pound, when you go back to January 3rd, you're at 124. You're at 130, 179. It rejected a lower price out here today, came back to its strength from the 26th of February. That pound wants higher price. And, of course, that's going to be all about Brexit. What's the extension going to be? Are they going to pass it? We know there's going to be no hard Brexit now, and that's been helpful for the market over there in general. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the gold contract. Gold's going to need more volume, folks. Going to need more volume and more price spread. What we had out here today, you know, you had a low of 1284, high of 1291. It's really a sideways move. Didn't really do much. 185,000 contracts traded. If we go to look at the GDX, and this is going to be the culprit, Newmont, bottom line, GDX closed down 45 cents. That's challenging the lows of Monday. What you have on Monday, the low of Monday is 21.40. We hit 21.47. We went into this today with 46 million versus 55. So you have lighter volume, but that's saying that that's going to get challenged. The small caps are the big number out here today, folks, and it is a very large number. This was fast, furious, and pay attention to it, because if you go and look at the October level of how we come down, the September, well, actually, yes, and that's my point, I guess. Wow, look at that. It did. You know what happened? Is that the small caps, I got this up right now, the small caps actually start going south September 21st. That's where volume stopped blowing out. And it was really subtle. We only went down 1 point, but you had volume explode to the downside. You went sideways for about three more days, then volume came in again, 17 million. You get down to 167. Then volume came in again at 27 million. You get down to 165. And then the rest, as they say, is history. This actually move right here is actually more substantial than the move that was from September coming down. This was a very fast move on the way down, and there's not much holding this thing up. We just went into the bar from the 15th of February. We did 29 million versus 27. That's saying, guess what? You have more sellers than buyers. That would set up right now a 149.30, and we're at 153. And if we get the same amount of volume we got today, it'll blow that away too, because that's only 27 million shares. Yeah, looks to me like we get action, and the small caps are basically saying it's action downtown. We go take a look at the NDX 100. What do we have with the 3Qs? 3Qs, 26 million shares traded. You go higher yesterday with 22 million. You're coming into Mondays with 38. So the Qs are going to need more volume in order to break down. 172.47 is the number. We got to 173.28 today. That's going to need more juice for lower price. We go take a look at the Dow Industrials, the diamonds, what we have inside the diamonds out here. This is going to be interesting. Did that break? 256.20. Oh, stop right before it. Diamonds are going to be a problem. Yep, Dow's going to be a problem. The Dow looks like it wants to jump the creek, too. So that would be saying that we wake up in the morning and you're going to have these futures down a bit. Dow Industrials finished down 133, NASDAQ off 70, S&P's off 20. Come right back.
folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere, hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. So this is going to get kind of cool watching how this is going to shake out, folks. So, you know, about a year and a half ago, Amazon, JP Morgan, as well as Berkshire, had got together, said that they're going to open a healthcare company, specifically for their own business first. So we got this baby up and going. They just named it today. So the mysterious new healthcare venture announced by Amazon, Berkshire Hathaway, as well as JP Morgan, will be called Haven. Haven also unveiled its website, havenhealthcare.com. What they plan on doing is that they're going to improve access to primary care, simplify insurance, and make prescription drugs more affordable. According to their website, it's initially going to serve the 1.2 million employees of Amazon, Berkshire, and JP Morgan. And what they're saying on their website, although it later plans to share our innovations and solutions to help others. Haven was formed because of its founding companies have been frustrated over the quality, service, and high cost that their employees and families have experienced in the U.S. healthcare system. The website is the most detailed information yet about the year-old venture that generated excitement inside the healthcare industry. Well, I bet it generated excitement inside the healthcare industry, but not if you are one of the healthcare middlemen. It also raised fears among health insurance, drug makers, and other parts of the industry that the giant companies backing Haven would use their collective power to disrupt established players. That's the name of the game, man. You know, the bottom line, which would be really cool here, we get a lot of this happening too, folks, okay, is that So the way that this company set up, now let's go through this, because this is going to be pretty cool if they, if it shakes out what they, you know, say they are going to do. They, the CEO was writing that will be an advocate for the patient and will ally to anyone who wants to improve patient care and costs. The company will create new solutions and work to change systems, technologies, contracts, policies, and whatever else is in the way of better care. The bottom line, folks, is that it's going to be the bureaucracy in the middle and the amount of payoffs, legal payoffs, that is, that get done inside the healthcare industry. In addition to, let's see, board members include, the board members are basically offices of Berkshire, JP Morgan, and Amazon. The companies have characterized the venture as a long-term effort that would be free from profit-making incentives and constraints. Haven will reinvest any surplus into its work, according to the website. The venture has recently been entangled in a legal conflict with United Health's Optum Group. Optum sued a former employee, David William Smith, to enforce a non-compete agreement after he was hired by Haven. A federal judge in Massachusetts last night denied Optum's motion for a temporary restraining order to keep Smith from starting work and sent the case to arbitration. Let's go take a look at United Health. Because what you're going to have out here, folks, if they stick to the aspect of the that it's going to be nonprofit, that they're going to basically bargain and they're going to try to reduce prices, this is going to be a win for many people. There's no two ways about that. If you look at United Health, you can see United Health has been getting banged down since 287. You're at 283 right now. Now, this company makes money hand over fist. Yeah, let me just show you this for a second. Yeah, so they took in $157 billion in 2015. This year, they took in $226 billion. They're still growing by 11%, and Optimum is growing by 14% per year. Amazing. They plan on doing $244 billion this coming year. That's almost $1 billion a week, folks. And to the bottom line, they bring $14.64 to the bottom line, which is a big number. You know, the cool thing is, and you can see how it's set up, what has happened is the aspect of the, there we go, the all those employees, they have an incentive to also bring the cost down, because the bottom line is that those companies are huge employees. They're paying parts of that bottom line. You know, we'll see whether this gets done. But it looks to me like it's going to be a start to basically get the chunk out of the middle inside of that healthcare business. And it's a huge chunk. There's no two ways about that. Some of the other higher volume equities out here today, well, actually, let's go look at BJ's. BJ's came out with numbers this morning, and this equity, bottom line, I think the numbers were pretty good, but man, they sold this thing off quick. So let me see what they had to say out here. And you have Costco coming out tomorrow. So the earnings per share number was 37 cents. They made 44. So that was good. Revenue, $3.3 billion. They made 3.42. Bottom line, both of those were fine. They see fiscal year net sales. That's what hit them. So check this. This is a yin and yang deal. So for the fiscal year, they had an estimate of $13.41 billion. Then they brought that down to 12.9 to 13.2. And if you want to see, comp sales were up 2.8%. They were looking for 2.9. Bottom line is that this stock had taken pretty quick. They opened it at its high. You know, bottom line, they got this thing opened up at 27.47. It pops to 28.11 and then gives it up on spades. I mean on spades. This thing, you sold it off all day long. We bring this back now for a couple years. Yeah, it's not a good scene. Not the end of the world, but let's go take a look at Costco. Costco, I think, is coming out at 6 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. Oh, no, 4:15 tomorrow, 4:15. So after the close, Costco comes out. And it looks to me like Costco is going to be a problem, too. The reason being is that Costco took a deep dive. Maybe this was when they come out with their last numbers On December 13th, Costco closed at 229. It opened the next day down at 218 and went to 205. And you're jamming into that number with tremendously lighter volume. You know, we did 1.9 million today. You're going into 8.8. That's saying that, let's see what they're looking for. So they're going to be looking for revenue of $35 billion, and they're going to be looking for a bottom line of $1.69. And the way Costco is set up, they're still growing by 6%. These numbers are impressive. I mean, for, you know, huge, look at that. It's pretty amazing. So the warehouse clubs, folks, they've taken $138 billion, but just on membership fees, they're in the billions, $3.1 billion. The clubs are growing by 6.7%. The memberships are growing by 7.4%. So in both cases, you get some decent numbers out here. Micron Tech, we take a look at Micron. Micron out here today had volume on the way down. This is going to be, you know, for the NDX 100 as well as the NASDAQ, this is going to be a heads up. Volume came out of this today. We hit 37.32, 37.36 is the swing point. That's going to be going after that swing. And that was a quick move lower. We were at $43.99 10 trading days ago. You know, $5 on a $40 stock is pretty intense in as few as 5 trading days, folks. There's no doubt about that. Dow Industrials finished down 133. NASDAQ up 70. S&P down 20. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour,
followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at the transports. Now, check this out. This is pretty wild. Of course, the transports, that's what bottom line keeps everything moving, folks. So people like paying attention to them. And when we take a look at this, what you're going to see is the last high in the transports was generated out here on the 25th of February. That high was 10,672. Now, want to hear a stat? This is quite a stat. The transports, I talk about subtle moves, stealth moves. This is a subtle move. But statistically, this is a very large move. We haven't moved 9 straight days down in 10 years inside the transports. How's that? Now, it's not a large move. That being said, though, when you take a look at this and I bring this back, bottom line is that the transports topped out in September of 2018, 11,620. That's $1,400 higher than we are. It ran into your downdraft from October of this year, of 2018, actually. December 2017, of 2018. Ran into it like a sledgehammer and just gave it up. So the transports also look to me like they actually are going right along with the small caps on the way south. Let's take a look at a few of these. So you got the mover out here today. Kansas City, that's a railroad. That was the move. That was up 8 points. You had Norfolk Southern and J.B. Hunt. They were the only ones that were in the positive aspect. So let's take a look at the strongest one for today, Kansas City, just to see what that looks like. So the low for the year is 90. The high is 120. It was trading at 111. Bring this back. Yep. Now these things are topping out too. Yeah, you're slamming into, and Kansas City's deal, you're slamming right into October downdraft. And now this one here, it's not that it's the strongest equity, it's the strongest equity today. Now let me look at the weakest equity today, which was Alaskan Air. That was down 3.7%. Oh, look at this poor deal. It's hit the low today. $55.83. The high, 74. What the heck's wrong with this? Alaskan Air. I haven't been on Alaskan Air a long period of time, but pretty good airline. This is a problem. Look at this. Whoa, baby. Whatever's happened with Alaskan Air. Okay, so Alaskan Air is breaking its whole consolidation. Let me pull this back. I got it 15 years, but that's a little too far to look at it. Yeah, so Alaskan Air, You've been in a consolidation since January of 18. The bottom of that consolidation is 57.28. You broke it. Yeah. So next stop is 53.79. And what's so bad about Alaskan Air right now? So looks like they're still they're growing, but you have something that's not great. Well, they're selling it. That's the bottom line. Stocks go down, folks, they're selling it. Stocks go up, they're buying it. Let's go take a look at the second one. So the second one is Matson. Let's see what this company does. Matson, huh? Transportation logistics company offering multi-model transportation service in North America, including domestic, international rail, intermodal service, long-haul, regional highway brokerage, supply chain services. Okay, so they look like they put everything together logistically. Let's say a company's going to bring something from the rail to the service center, to the supply chain to the delivery mechanism. That's what it looks like it is. This is stationed in Honolulu. Oh, interesting. Okay, so boats, trains, and planes for sure. And this little baby trading at 35. Yeah, same setup. This is going lower. FedEx, FDX. Let's go take a look at FedEx. We know FedEx is in there. Yeah, poor FedEx. Who would ever think you'd say poor FedEx? Well, guess what? When Amazon's in your business, it's poor FedEx now. FedEx is down from 274, and you're trading 178. 274 was generated out here January of 2018. What FedEx hasn't done yet is gone after its high volume low at 150. So that's a little problem child. UPS, let's go take a look at UPS. You got, that's at 108. A lot better looking than FedEx. Look at that. Wow, what a difference. This is going to be interesting to see why that's such a differential. This is pretty impressive, actually. You get, and what you know what that may be? It may be that they just didn't do as much business with FedEx and, I mean, with Amazon. It's hard to tell. But this is still a good-looking chart, you know. Not the best-looking chart, but it's certainly not looking like FedEx. And if we look at the numbers on UPS, $58 billion, 15, $75 billion this year. Yeah. I'm not quite sure why that is set up like that. Let's go look at one more inside those transports. Let's see. Oh, Avis. Why not? Avis budget rent-a-car. Low's 21 for the year. The high's 50. This just came off the lows of 21, went up to 34. And that might be off the lows. No? Yeah. I mean, this is down from 68 going all the way back in 2014, but this is a pretty good test of the lows. You know, we came down in January. You did 12 million shares versus the test of 31. You rejected lower price. Then what you did do is you had a sign of strength in February. This might be an equity you want to take a look at on any types of pullbacks, because what you have here, it looks like the top of the consolidation is $50. You're only at 34. You wait for a pullback. Let's might go a little bit lower, because that break topside in February, that's a decisive break, meaning you had the wide price spread. We went from 25 to 36. You had the expansion of volume, 16.7 million. That's what you're looking for when you're looking for equities that you think have reached the bottom. What's cool about something like this is that it has tested this low four separate times since January of 2016, you know. And remember something, the more that you, it's frustrating, but the more that you either test a high or test a low, the more information that it gives you. And when you test it four times, each one of those times it had lighter volume, it rejected it, then what did it do? It come off that low, wide price spread, accelerated volume. That is saying that you get a fund that's involved in it, you get a big buyer that's involved in it. That's how this baby moves higher. And then if you have something like that, then what do? You turn around and wait for a retracement. You buy the retracement. As long as the retracement is on lighter volume, you get a top of the consolidation you're looking for. The bottom of consolidation is your stop. You're off to the races. Dow finished down 133. NASDAQ off 70. S&P's off 20. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Deutsche Bank. So we've been hearing about Deutsche Bank forever, folks. Bottom line is that we'll see whether when they're going to not that they're going to put it out of its misery, but the German government's going to have to come in with this. You can just see it in the chart itself. $125 at in 07, you're at $9. If I bring this closer, you're going to see there's just nothing here, man. I mean, this thing is just bouncing along the bottom, hoping that it can basically get some juice. They come out today. And let's see what the Deutsche Bank employees learned their bonuses on Wednesday. And guess what, folks? Their bonuses in most of the bankers in New York and London are going to have the egg zero. Now, what that's going to do ASAP, folks, is they're going to lose the few good brokers that they probably have, because when you get in a banker, zero bonuses in the financial business. That's not how it works. The banking industry makes not more than their pay, but many of them make more than their pay on their bonuses. Many of those who avoided large cuts in their 2018 bonuses did so because they had guaranteed payouts and they were actually recent new hires. Deutsche Bank cut the bonus pool for 2018 to less than $2.3 billion, and that is 10 to 15% lower than 2017. The bank is making more selective payouts in an attempt to keep top earners. We know how many scandals they're in. The embattled lender has faced numerous scandals in recent years. It feels like they've been in scandals for like at least 15 years. Deutsche Bank's equity trading unit lost $750 million last year, and the bank has considered closing the entire equities operation. Yeah, it'd be probably a good idea. Their profit plunged 48% this year. They had a trade on, folks, and this was a couple weeks ago that we were just talking about. And what it was that, picture this. So if you and I buy a bond, whatever we buy, okay, it's in your brokerage account, it's mark to market every day, right? Bottom line is that, and by the way, Deutsche Bank got away with this even with the regulators, is that they had a trade from 2007. They had these bonds that they were claiming the bonds were worth more money. Well, bottom line is that they weren't, and they had to write off $15 billion about 2 weeks ago. And the amazing part to me is that they basically shop around until they find what accountant's going to say that, no, we can do this. Pretty amazing. And in fact, let me tell you, and I go for that story. This is really a sad story because this was when so many people got killed. Valley. Okay, so Valley is one of the largest producers of iron ore in the world. Low is $10, the high is $16. Trades at $12.49. Now, what you have here, regardless of what I say on the story, it looks to me like this thing bottomed. If you have the gold report, my take is that when we came down, we did the test on the 8th of February. I suspect it bottomed. This is going to take some time to build the damage down on the way down. But listen to this story. This is a disgusting story as to the aspects of what large corporations can do. And I'm not blaming all large corporations, that's for sure, because you can't throw everyone under the bus when these things come out. But here it is, this is crazy. I mean, this was in the Wall Street Journal the other day, that they had an auditor that, bottom line, would not certify that dam was safe. He knew the dam wasn't safe, so he wouldn't certify it. You know what they did, folks? They fired him. They brought in another auditor that they had used in the past, okay? And then they certified it. It's like, you got to be kidding me, man. I mean, that's criminal. That's definitely criminal. We'll see if anyone gets fried for that. But bottom line is that when you read that, it's like, you got to be kidding me. I mean, who makes that decision? Bad scene. And you wouldn't. Yes. And let me show you this too, though. This is what's really sick. This is not a company here. I'm gonna bring this up. This is not a company that doesn't make money. They take in $136 billion a year. They take to the bottom line $5 a year, $5 to $6. So, it's one thing making an excuse, oh, I don't have the money to fix it. They have their cash flow is astronomical, So that's why people get fed up with large institutions, large companies, when there's never enough. There's never enough. They push. They don't care whether a dam goes down, whether people go down, or what happens. And then they walk away and do it all over again. Not good. Some of the higher, well, actually, let's go look at the volume and see what we did in the indices out here. So in the NYSE, we did 988. That's shot volume. That's shot volume for sure. And the NASDAQ composite, we did 2.2. That's normal volume. We did 2.1 yesterday, 2.2 today. The composite itself, we're at 7505. So 7572. Yeah, well, the composite has to get under 7486. That's the high of the 3rd of December in order to basically get in that lower range. Small caps already did in spades, no doubt about that. If we go look at the Dow Industrials, 25,980, yeah. That's interesting. So these are set up a little bit differently. The Dow's down it too. The Dow bottom line is under it, and that's a little subtle, no doubt. NDX 100, that's still above it. NDX would have to get under 7106. We're getting there. You're 7112 right now. So it's not that far away. No doubt about it. We go take a look at, is it A? forgot who just came out with numbers. One of these babies just came. Oh, yeah. If you want to see here, one of our tigers was just talking about the TZA. Yeah, if you want to see a nice pop on one of these direction 300% moves, TZA today takes off like a rocket ship. And you have the price, you have volume, you have everything. In fact, if you look at the TZA, what you're going to see is pretty amazing, actually. Comes down to where the strength was in October 5th. That was $9.08. You had 21 million shares there. We tested that with 8 million. Crazy. Has a pop last Thursday. Last Thursday is a big day. See, that was last Thursday was really subtle, folks. You came down. You had a huge pop on volume, though, and the TZA did it. The TZA goes from $9 to $9.56, does 13 million, falls through today. This TZA, man, this thing wants to go up to $14 in about a heartbeat. It's going to be interesting. 14 is the low that was established out here in January 2nd. It's not, once this thing gets rolling, and if you're used to trading these doubles or triples, folks, the $10 area is kind of a sweet area trading them, because the expansion or contraction at that level was pretty intense. Dow finished down 133, NASDAQ off 70, S&P's down 21. We're coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. And, folks, if we go over, you know, let's go look at Shanghai market. Now, I wouldn't be buying the Shanghai right now, but let me tell you something. You're going to want to buy a retracement on this. This baby came off the December lows and is up 25%. And it has it all, folks. It has the price. It has the volume. This is how, bottom line, these things like to trade. You know, December, January 4th, you're at the 2440. You're at 31 right now. Now, watch this. If we take this and just put this back on a long-term basis, what you're going to see is that when you get these rallies in China, man, they're huge. Like the last big rally, it started in July of 2014 at 2033. It's nonstop up to 5,100, and then bang, see ya. I just wait for a pullback. This one looks to me like I can go to 3,500. You're at 31, you know, and they'll get a pullback. And guess what? If you have volume at 35, you get a lot more game underneath it. It's a classic, you know, it really is a classic. You pull back, long pullback, it pulled back to where they start going topside in 2014, and it did have lighter volume, which is just amazing. I mean, same type of setup. And then you came off of that low, and you came off of that low with big volume. There's, I get this on the daily right now. I'll put it on a 1 month, you can see it even clearer. It's pretty, it's fast and furious. And you have just about every sector out there. What's going to get intriguing is that, of course, we have all the news that everything's slowing down, bottom line. It looks to me like, you know, this market wants to go lower, but it looks to me like we already actually made it through the slowdown. Because if you do have the aspect that Shanghai is off those lows, you know, and we had the December downdraft, it doesn't mean that we're not going back down. But what you have there is that if all those stocks start pumping it out again, that is saying that they're growing. We're definitely growing, okay? Bottom line, you get two of the largest economies in the world growing. You know, guess what? Cash flow-wise, you're going to be at a higher price. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it, step into it, take ownership, and fly with it. Look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Go get them, folks.